cannot actually give exact my age.
Okay.
But I'm in the early
20s.
Yeah. I'm in the early 20s and okay. I completed my grade 12 in 2011.
Okay.
That's from Mans High School in Lafula, where I actually got some interest in the things of God just after, before writing my grade 12.
Okay.
And I remember it was so interesting because I was after this young girl. Mm-hmm. I was called young, vibrant, and dedicated to the things of God.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so after dating her for a few days, I heard her mentioning so much about me giving my life to the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And by that time, I was one of the Jehovah's Witnesses.
Mm-hmm.
And very committed, by the way. And after that, I had an encounter with the Lord Jesus Christ. I gave my life to the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, I had differences with my parents, mm-hmm. being one person who's coming from a Jehovah's Witness background. It was quite difficult for my parents to accept me, my transition.
Mm-hmm.
So I gave up on everything that my parents actually opted to give me, and I decided to follow my passion for my fashion.
Okay.
And I would say a few years later, I was in Bible school, graduated with an associate degree in theology and biblical studies.
Okay.
That is out of our country, that is Liberia.
Mm-hmm.
When I came back to Zambia, actually, I had a passion to work outside.
Mm-hmm.
That the Lord spoke to me and told me to say, you are a Zambian, and I called you to serve the Zambia. That's how I came back to Zambia, started my ministry. Pastor Genesis is single but not available.
Mm-hmm.
I'm an engaged young man.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I'm a father of one.
Okay.
And just to announce in advance that the coming 21st September actually will be my wedding.
Oh,
so
nice.
That's all I can say about Pastor Genesis. I'm the founder and the president of the ministry called the Royal Believers Assembly.
Okay.
Yes.
So I'd also like to find out now, at what particular point did your parents get to accept that you're transitioning from Jehovah's Witness to?
Rhoda, I'll be frank with you to say, I expected them to be so happy with me, but looking at how they raised me, I remember like when I was 8, mom would carry me, going to the field, exchanging brochures and conducting Bible studies. But I remember very, very, very well, there's a time when both of them actually never accepted. And up to now, I would say 25%.
Wow.
They've accepted, but thank God I have the support of my young brother, my immediate young brother, Gerard, who is now a student from the University of Zambia.
Mm-hmm.
He's the one that I've seen actually supported and encourages me. Most of the time, he'd come back to me and tell me, I think this is what you decided to do. You dropped out from school. You wanted to work for God.
Mm-hmm.
So I would say 25% have accepted that.
Okay.
And my prayer is that 75% of the time I'll be joining this program will be on their side to support.
Okay, but I'd also like to find out, why exactly did you transition? Is it the fact that when you're with Jehovah's Witness, you can't study what you studied?
Okay, the Jehovah's Witness, to me, I always tell people in most of the interviews where I've featured,
mm-hmm.
I've told them to say, one thing that actually really, really pushes me forward is what I learned from Jehovah's Witness, because that was my first Bible school, I would say. You know how they brought up their children?
Mm-hmm.
So I learned a lot about scripture translations and other stuff. So and the reason why I changed, this is where I'll be so frank and bold about it. It's about salvation.
Mm-hmm.
It's about your encounter with the Lord. There's nothing with Jehovah's Witnesses, but according to the call of God upon my life, it would have been so difficult for me to express and preach in the manner that the Lord God preached me in this from Jehovah's Witness. So to those that are still witnesses, I won't say they are with a bad denomination, but they are doing the right thing.
Mm-hmm.
But it's all about the call of God and your encounter with the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay. Now, today we're talking about how youths can be instrumental to the community and the country at large.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you are going to speak from a biblical point.
Yes.
But when we say youths can be instrumental, what exactly do we mean by instrumental?
When we talk about instrumental, I'll go back to science, where we try to define a machine. where everybody will say a machine is any device that makes the work easier.
Yeah.
So a machine becomes an instrument at that particular time. So an instrument is something that you use to make things happen. So when we say the youth can be instrumental to the nation and the world at large, what you are saying is, despite our generation, despite obstructions, still youth stands a chance to change the world. They can use the youth as an instrument to change the world and make things work and become easier.
Okay. What do you think about the youth today? And I always like to, just hear people's views on how we are moving as a country in terms of youth leadership and also in terms of just contributing to the development of this country.
I'm one person who believes so much in the youth because I'm a youth. And every most talked about leader and icon today who are actually making it big in this world, they were once youths. And in their times when they were youths, nobody neglected them, because they believe these people are growing up. So what I think about the youth of today, it is from the saying that I read in one of the most powerful books written by Dr. Miles Monroe, who said, the seeds of today are the flowers of tomorrow. So despite what the nation, the world has for the youth of today, me, I have got this feeling to say, there's a chance for them to change and make things right. So I believe so much in the youths because of their abilities in them, because of how much they are too energetic. I'll give you an example of what the Bible says, where the Bible says, in the end I shall pull out my spirit on the flesh, your young ones shall have dreams, the elder ones shall dream dreams, then your sons and daughters shall prophesy. There's one thing that I picked there about the old men to dream. You know, for someone to have a dream, it's automatically they'll be sleeping. So, the things that you're going to dream is what you're going to share to the youths. Why? Because your dream was so big that you are old enough, you are not energetic to work on what God showed you in your dreams. So, the best you do is to handle that to the youths who are so energetic that they can do things. What is needed to see the youths become so instrumental in this world or this generation is when we begin to introduce them to the things that can build up their minds, and at the end of the day they will stand on their ground and say, this is what I really want to do. And at the end of the day they won't do it for the sake of their for the sake of their benefits, but it's for this generation. Lord, I'll tell you the truth to say, if your children, let me say your daughter, comes and achieve exactly things that you've achieved, rather you failed as a parent. Your child must be double of what you got or what you achieved. So the youths, if we introduce them to things that can really, really actually build them up, it means they are beating the previous generation that where they are coming from. Those are actually their parents. So when we introduce them to things that are more productive, I tell you, the youths will be more instrumental to change the face of this world. I always tell people to say, the youths are the ones that have got the right bent to bend the face of the earth. But if we neglect them and begin to think like these guys are going nowhere, what we are building in them is they are nothing. So they are opt to do nothing even after 5 years. I read another book by Dr. Miles Monroe about maximizing your potential. He told me, What you are reading today is who you become, is who you are going to become in the next 5 years. So if again we introduce proper literature to the youths of today, the knowledge they are getting from the books is exactly what they feed their generation. And I'm telling you, the outcome, everybody will say, without a youth, the world will still remain.
Yeah. Now, how can we, in what ways can we be instrumental? Let's start from community level.
Yeah.
Now, we know that we've always been saying, let's not rely on the government, let's do certain things on our own, but how exactly can we be instrumental? Just maybe okay. Some examples.
Okay. I will say how one can become so instrumental. I will try to put a distinction between these two words, reputation and integrity. In most cases, people say, I would rather protect my reputation than you destroy my name.
Mm.
But when we try, I'm not just forgotten, according to our dictionary, will actually give us the meaning of the word reputation. But the reputation is how someone thinks about you.
Mm-hmm.
But your integrity is how you portray yourself to the community. So this is a moment where I'm seeing the youths of today. We are trying to protect the so-called reputation, which has nothing to do with our lives, mm-hmm. and we are forgetting about our integrity. So how a youth will become so instrumental to the community, starting from the community, is actually to deliver the best that is in them to the community. How? I'll give you an example of what is happening in Mozambique, Zimbabwe, and Malawi. You've seen what is happening. And our prayer is that God would come for our neighboring countries. By the fact that you have something that you can use, you can come up with a movement, get three or four. The Bible says two can never walk together unless there's an agreement.
Mm-hmm.
You can get four or five people, you go door to door to get clothes that are not of use. Then from there, you find where you can actually donate them and keep them in our homes. The change that everybody who have been expecting or anticipating starts with one person. There's a very powerful saying in America which they say, you can never spread the word united without you.
Mm-hmm.
When you remove you from united, you can't spread that word.
Mm-hmm.
Some even to us church. My first word I saw in Bible school was church.
Mm-hmm.
Church is spelled C-H-U-R-C-H. When you remove you out of church, you can't spell the word church.
Mm-hmm.
It will be actually out of land. So everything that must bring a best recommendation, everything must put a credit, a distinction to every situation that is happening in our community, must start with one person. And that person is you, is me, is who is watching me right now. That's how we can become so instrumental from the community. I'll give you an example. I stay in Kawata.
Mm-hmm.
Kawata Site and Service. I love Putebo. So when I have my free time after my studies, by the way, I forgot I'm pursuing my master's now in theology. So what I do when I'm done with my studies, I'll go to Putebo, try to play Putebo, and I'll find young men there. They're about 13, 15 years old, but they listen to their language. Feel their anger when they're talking. They tell that something is wrong.
Mm-hmm.
But my purpose of going to play pool there is to make sure before I leave, one soul must be at least be touched to my testimony or to my story.
Mm-hmm.
And I've changed more than 23 young men from that. And we are having programs where I'll sit them down and give them words that can actually build up their lives. It starts from the community. Recognition, they say real recognize real.
Mm-hmm.
After that, people will come and say, this guy has got so much. Why don't we do this? Why don't we do that? From the community, I'll become so instrumental. Not without anybody bringing something in my pocket to push me to do what I'm doing. That's why in the first place I said, follow your passion before you follow your fashion. Because what your passion is what introduces you to your fashion. By providing what God has deposited into you, then definitely you are becoming more instrumental to your community.
Okay. And at country level, we have seen that we do not have enough youth participation when it comes to decision making and also maybe just representation in government.
Yeah. On the issue of, I would say, national leadership rights, I won't use the word politics,
mm-hmm.
because when we say politics, everybody will think of it's campaigning and stoning others. But when we talk about the national leadership race,
mm-hmm.
it is one thing that I've advised most of the young people to be into. I'll disclose this on public to say I'm one person who have actually met Dr. Nicholas Mwamba twice. One reason is that I have that dream of one day becoming a leader.
Mm-hmm.
of this nation. I might start from the councillor, MP, until God says yes. I can actually even stand as one of the presidents. I have a brother who is a former Kobadot University president, Njiko Musuk, who is young and vibrant. We are of the same age. As I'm talking to you, he's standing as a councillor from Mansa. When we bring the young men in parliament, at the national level, what we are trying to tell our elders who have gone ahead of us is that we have the ability to do what you're doing, and our minds are fresh. What we need from them is to bring us close and show us the way we're supposed to do things. But in most cases, I'll use these words, our elders that we have in whatever institution, when they see a young, vibrant young man comes closer with more ability, they got so intimidated for no reason. But if we sit on them, step on them, we are killing a seed that is about to germinate. So the youths can actually come up, if there's something like that, come up with organizations. Like I've heard about PPZ, I've heard about SEC, I've heard about YTP. These are young men that have gathered themselves to try to involve themselves into national leadership. Mm-hmm. How they'll become too instrumental to the nation is to go around sensitized so much about the national leadership politics in inverted commas, how it should be done and how it will help the generation that is coming. I'll tell you the truth to say that the youths that we have, me, I believe so much in them. I'll give you an example of the president of France, mm-hmm. who is a young man. I've never heard any report to say he's done this, he's done that, despite him getting married to an old woman, of which is not actually the problem to anyone who really understand what the issue of the heart is all about. So the youths can be so instrumental to the nation when they get involved into the national leadership race. That is leadership in particular, because the Bible says promotion never comes from the east, south, west, only it comes from God.